precipitate the DNA from solution by adding an equal volume of 100% ethanol to each sample. And mix by inversion 10 times. The solution may become cloudy. This is normal. After incubating at room temperature for 5 minutes, place the samples in the microcentrifuge with the hinges facing outward. Remember to balance your tubes. Spin the samples for 2 minutes. Remove the tubes from the centrifuge gently, being mindful not to disturb the pellet which now contains your DNA. Visually inspect for a pellet at the bottom of the tube on the side of the hinge. A pellet is not always visible, so you can choose to centrifuge again or proceed as normal. In this example, a pellet is only seen in samples C and D, but all samples are carried through the process. Using a P1000, slowly remove and discard approximately 800 microliters of supernatant. Place the tip at the bottom of the tube on the opposite side of the pellet to avoid disturbing it. It is not important at this point that all solution is removed. Just get as much as possible. Expel the tip, with the solution inside, into the discard bucket. Repeat this process for all remaining samples. Visually inspect the tube to see if this pellet is still present. If it has gone missing, make a note of that. Clean the DNA pellet by adding 250 microliters of 70% ethanol to each sample. Thank you. Do not mix the solution, as it is imperative that the pellet is not disturbed. Repeat this process for all remaining samples. Place the samples in the centrifuge, being mindful of balance, and spin for 2 minutes. Remove the tubes from the centrifuge carefully. In this step, the pellet still contains the DNA, and it is important to remove as much supernatant as possible without disturbing the pellet. So remove and discard the supernatant using the P200 for precision. This will take 2 or more draws. On the first draw, you can expel the solution into the discard bucket and use the same tip to draw up again, as long as the tip has not touched other surfaces. Repeat this process for the remaining samples. Lay out a few layers of Kim wipes. Open the tube and knock it onto the Kim wipe to remove any large volumes of solution still remaining. Leave the tube open and lay it on its side to evaporate any of the remaining solution from the pellet. Repeat this process for all remaining samples and allow them to air dry for 20 to 30 minutes. If the tube still has spots of solution or if the pellet does not look dry, allow for evaporation to continue. If the pellet looks dry, then resuspend the DNA using water. Add 100 microliters of molecular biology grade water directly onto the pellet side. Cap the tube and mix by vortexing for a few minutes. Visually inspect the tube to ensure that the pellet has disappeared or has gone back into solution. If it has not, then continue to vortex or allow the tube to sit at room temperature before proceeding to subsequent steps. Repeat this for all remaining samples.